Hello everyone and welcome to my learning channel. In today's video, I'm gonna teach you how to use your computer or laptop for the first time, lesson number 2, after orientation. Today I'm gonna show you how to create a folder, how to download another browser except the one that came with your laptop, and few more useful things. Stay with me. To create a folder anywhere you are on your File Explorer or right here on your desktop area, you click right on your mouse and you're gonna have option for new folder. Press that, give a name to your new folder, utility, let's call it, and you can put things in it. For example, from my finished videos, I'm gonna put an image on the new utility folder. I open the folder I want. For example, if you're gonna attach a memory stick or a card to your computer, you just take it from here with left click, hold it and drop it in the folder where you want the object to be moved, the file, folder or image. And now if I'm gonna open this, we have this one, the image that we just moved, right there. I'm gonna put it back because I don't need it in the new folder. To delete a folder, you right click on it and you have option to delete it. Easy things, probably you know this, but I have to pass them for the people who don't know this. You're gonna have only Microsoft Edge, the new browser, or an E from the old Edge if you haven't upgraded it to the new Edge. But most probably you're gonna have this icon with the name Microsoft Edge browser. If you open this, you have access to browse internet. You can go on website like YouTube where you are learning those tutorials. Let's go. Let's type Yo and select from here YouTube. And the first website is gonna be the official YouTube website. In here you can handle it. I think you click on the videos you want to see. But what if I want to have another browser? You see I have Google Chrome as second browser here. Let's see how we can install a second browser. You open Edge and type in download. Usually you write to everything you want to download and you're gonna find it if you are careful and read the instructions. I want to download Firefox. It's another good browser. I already have Google Chrome, but if you want to download Google Chrome, the most searched browser and used probably, you do the same thing as I'm gonna do for Firefox now. So let's go ahead and type Firefox, download Firefox. The first one, from Microsoft, they are telling you you're already browsing in the new Microsoft Edge. Why to download the Because I want so, I want to download a new Firefox. I do whatever I want, not. You press on download now. Firefox is more than a browser. The download has started. You see it on the left here. You press on open file. Installation is gonna start. Close the previous browser, the Microsoft Edge. And installation of Mozilla Firefox. It's started. Alright, installation of Firefox is complete. We have it right here next to our Chrome browser. Let's not open it yet. Okay. Let's see a small. What's the difference between browsers? It's the orientation in page most of the time. For example, you have some small differences between browser and you like more to use because you are more comfortable how the buttons are, or the, I don't know, not now, I don't want default. This is on Mozilla Firefox and this is on Edge. Yes, the way you have the settings, maybe you understand them more on another browser. You have them usually it's in the same position as you see. you have sign in, new window, private window browsing, zoom your text, make it bigger or smaller from here. You have all the options here, and on Edge, Microsoft Edge browser, you have most the same settings here, and I'm absolutely sure they're on the Google Chrome as well. Let's go to Google Chrome. Yes, you have those three dots here, and you have all the settings of the browser here. So I have opened the three browsers now. We just installed Mozilla Firefox. On Mozilla, we want to go to YouTube, like we did on Microsoft Edge. You type in YouTube on the search, first one is gonna appear. The first website is YouTube. You go on YouTube, and here you have YouTube on the new browser. This is how you install a new browser. It's the same method for all browsers you want. Maybe you heard that it's another browser is better than this one. Or you have to test all of them to see which one you are getting more familiar or you like more. Now let's see. You installed all the browsers, but you are not using only one. For example, you are using Microsoft Edge. You just installed to see how other browsers are, and now you want to get rid of them. How we get rid of them? Search box, if you remember from first episode on orientation. If you don't know the first episode how to use your laptop or computer, check the link in the description and see first episode for orientation. And type here add remove programs or uninstall. I typed uninstall and it showed me, but you can type add remove programs. Select it from the left list, search the item you want to uninstall here, or scroll from here down until you get to the item. In our case, let's uninstall Mozilla. I'm not using it on this laptop. Let's go to Mozilla and press uninstall. Sure, yes, I'm sure. Next, uninstall. Finish. And now you don't have Firefox anymore between your programs. The same way you do it everything you want to uninstall. This any application has uninstall options. Press uninstall. So we learned today how to create a folder with right click, new folder, how to move an object, file, folder or image from one folder to another. You just left mouse and move it. How to delete a folder if you don't want it anymore, right click and delete. And how to download and install a new browser, except the one it came with your laptop or computer, the Microsoft Edge that you have for as default on Windows. And how to uninstall a browser that you don't want to use anymore or you don't like it for any reason. This was lesson number 2. I hope it was easy to understand. If you have questions about anything on this lesson, on the previous lesson, or you want to learn something, write me in the comments. I'd be happy to help you. Don't hesitate to write me in the comments. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one. Bye.